Excuse me. Right, so where are we? I've ploughed on a little bit. I forgot to take the video. But I said I wasn't going to build these because I want to get the fibres up through there. But I found a little way of doing it as a track. There's a gap right up there. Might not be able to see it, but if it focuses, I don't know. I don't know, you can see it, but up there is a gap, and I might be able to get the fibre optic along there, but when putting these sides on, part of the plastic behind it actually fills that gap. So in actual fact, I still think I'm going to have to drill, so I might have to, you can just drill down there, through these pieces here and then out that side. That one's gonna be a bit harder there because it's got the connector piece on it, which puts it onto the actual main body. But this side isn't. That should be straightforward to go straight through there. So I went ahead and put these together. There's some bits I'm gonna have to get some clamps and just clamp it together and glue it a bit, because there's some bits that I'm not quite happy about. Again I haven't put all the extra bits on the side here, the pipe work, because of my fat thumbs. If I'm squeezing and stuff like that, it's gonna go squeeze together and probably break, knowing me. So I haven't done that. Let's get you out up there. Just gonna move the camera a bit because I tend to sit there, that's better. So yes, I've put that together, put all the pin sides there, so that's those two. Then I've taken these, pulled these out, and I have to now, very delicately, with this 5mm drill bit, drill through there. But it is going to be very delicate because that won't leave a lot of plastic at all on there. And the reason why I need to do that is because I need to get in there these 5mm LEDs. Now, as you can see at the moment, they don't go in there at all. So you have to widen it with the 5mm drill. So that is going to be my next job. Also, I've put a few of the other pieces on here for the spraying, which will be my job after I've done a bit of drilling. I think there's all the bits that need spraying that I need to take off the sprues like that. These two sprues, excuse me, I'm just going to spray on the sprues because it's going to be too fiddly, especially these bits which go on the back. It's just going to be way too fiddly trying to hold those and spray them at the same time. So it's just going to be easier just to spray it on there. Gun pieces don't really need because I'm not using those. Not the gun pieces, the landing gear, but I still just keep it on there, etc. So that is my where I am there on that. The top part I've filled in, that one, that piece there, that piece there, which was very simple, and that one there. I'm not sure at the moment until I spray. Actually, I'll probably spray first with the undercoat, and then put the beast for the gun turret here next, maybe. But at the moment, that's why I'm. And also, I've put together the stand just so you can see it, and I think that's going to be the orientation of the stand's going to be like that. So you can see that there. So you just, so that when you're looking at it through this way, you can see the under lighting was going to be. And also, because you're going to have the cockpit there, you'll be able to see the lighting there. So, and yeah, so I think that would be. And then from where I have it in my cabinet, you'll be able to see the engines just flickering slightly. So that's my orientation for the stand. So, yeah. That's where I am at the moment. I'm going to pause this now and try and drill out these bits for these. I'm going to have to do it on camera because there might be a bit of a effing and jeffing. So I'll be back to you. Right, this is actually more difficult than what it seems. I don't know if you can see, I've got one on there. Just if I take it otherwise, you probably might be able to see it a bit. So the light definitely comes through, but yeah, it's difficult, not as easy. I've managed to break one, but I think I can still get the LED in there. So yeah, I'll just try and demonstrate how difficult it is, but probably not because I've got to this isn't how I was doing it earlier actually. I was using a pair of pliers, which I should use really, rather than yeah, it's not easy. You see, because you squeeze it too hard and it distorts the plastic. You don't squeeze it hard enough and it pops out. So let's no, see, even I was doing it like that. No, I'm going to have to go back to doing it how I was originally doing it. And this is where it becomes, because you're trying to squeeze it to if I held it like that way, you can see that holding it that way. And but I say you've got to squeeze it hard enough. You see, you're squeezing it and then it just starts to squeeze it down, so you don't want to do that too much. So that one, well, that one went quite easily. So one, two, and then we'll do the third one, fourth one even. I should be able to repair that first one, I think. So there you go. That was quite relatively easy in the end. Must have been too heavy handed on the first one. So there you go, one, two, and I'll say that fourth one. Oh, I can glue that in. So that's the drilling done on that bit. And of course, as I said, they will sit on bottom half of there, they will sit all in there on those pegs like so. We just have one there, and then the other one will be there, and then yeah, that one was going to take a bit of gluing, I think, to keep that in. But let's just see if we can get the blue piece in there, shall we? And just see how that looks. Bear me 1 minute. Bear with, as I say. Bear with, young lad. Right, now does that one go in the bottom? Yes. So if we just put that on there. No, he's going to come out. I just want to... just to see what the effect is going to be like. I think it's going to be pretty smart. But not to they come out, that one. Where? Go on, go in now. Getting old. Oh, there's a bit of glare there, really, isn't there? Might have to try and defuse that somehow, because that looks a bit not as good as what I was hoping it was going to look now. So I might have to try and defuse that somehow, look into how I defuse them. But that's how they will look. Oh, you probably see it better there. One. Oh, that one, because you can't see that one because it's not pointing in the right direction. If you do that one there, like that, you can see it does give a flickery effect. But it's, no, I think it needs diffusing somehow. So, yeah, so that's where I am now. Drilled the holes for that. I've now got to look at to drilling the holes for the fibres, and then I think we from there we can then start to undercoat. Getting looking all right so far. I'm pretty pleased with that. I'm not sure that one broke, but a bit of glue in there and that'd be fine. So that's all good in the hood, as I say. But yeah, I do think that needs a bit of diffusion. Because if we turn the lights off, that is a bit. And I can't turn all the lights off. See, now the camera just overexposes it now and it doesn't look so good at all. And now let's put the light on as well. You've got a light boy. So. We'll see. Let me just put all the light back on. So I'm back in a bit. Right, okay. where was I? So I had to find some bits and pieces. Started drilling. I've drilled the hole. Might not be able to see it. Let me just turn that one off, it's a bit glary. Sorry, I'll have a cough. I've drilled a hole there, which is for the gun turret. I'm not quite decided what light I'm going to put in there, whether it's a warm light or the Movi light. Not quite sure which I'm going to do just yet. But it's a 3mm hole. I've also drilled a 3mm hole in the bottom there. That'd be for the wiring to come out of. I'm using some pictures off of the internet for reference as well, now where to do the rest of the fibres. Now, there's a picture there, there's two just below, around here, which is just in front of the front landing gear. So I decided I'd do that, and I've drilled two holes. You might be able to see them now with the light bit on there. But when I put the fibres in there, they seem a little bit, rattly. even though this is a 1mm drill bit. So I've hunted down I found the collets for this, because the little drill bit I'm going to use is too small to go on my big old drill. But I just want to show you how this will look if I can get it to stay in there. So they are a bit wobbly in this, but what I'll do is I'll just put a bit of glue behind. But can you see how that, you might not be able to see that red light behind there. I think that's going to, oh it's gone, it's disappeared. I think that's going to look pretty cool. There'll be two there, so that's where I'm now. Let me just get these lights, our fibres out of the way now. So as I said, I've got my Dremel, and now I'm going to start drilling where I want the rest of the fibres. It's a white fibre optic, so I'm going to have them around here. I'm going to go for, the only thing is in this picture, it doesn't show a ridge here, so it's just a guide really. But so I'll probably do a couple here. I've got 10 in total. Is it 8? I'll check that in a second. I better check there before I do too many holes, because I want the 2 at the front. So, but also I've got to try and drill here for the holes to go in there, for the fibre to go through there, because I don't think it's going to go through that gap. So I'll be back. Right, so I'm starting drilling the holes, but what I've noticed, the build-up of styrene on this little drill bit. Just even off after one hole, I'll show you. Now, I don't know if you can see that or not, focus, but that little bit, and if you do 2 or 3 holes, next thing you know, your hole's bigger than what you originally started with, wanted. Because I've noticed that on this hole here, it's a little bit bigger, so that's going to be a bummer. So what I've found now, that after each drilling of each hole, I'm just cleaning off the drill bit, because you don't want to have your holes too big. Also, which I didn't realise at the time, just clean this one off again. I was looking here at the drills, at the holes, and in where to put the lights in some of these pictures, from the pictures, and I was looking, okay, so roughly where about, and then I suddenly saw there's like these little indentations or things, and I don't know if you might see it, might not focus, I don't think it is. But just about there, is it going to see it? Probably not, won't focus. But there's a little, and that's where one of the lights comes. So that's all I've done along there. Now, as I've only got 8 left for underneath, I've missed out this one here and this one here. So I'm going to have 3 on the front. Then there's 1 there and 1 there on the back. And then obviously the 2 on the things at the front. I don't know what they're called. Sorry, I still don't know what they're called. So now, the next one is to do the 4 for the red fibres. Now, I've got to look to see if there's a specific place for these. And looking on the picture, and looking on here, I don't think there is. But, now, on his picture, he shows them quite right near to the door. But on, so you can't see on that picture, or there, but on Captain Jack's models, he's put them up quite round here, sort of thing. So I might try and do that, because I think that looks nicer than the other one. So I'm just going to look for that. And I'll be back, as they say. Oh, I tell you what. Let me just turn that off. He says drilling these for these, this isn't for the faint-hearted. And I'll tell you what. He ain't wrong, but I take them out. I mean, lights come on the camera now. Just cover that over. Look at that. That looks spot on. That looks, the camera's overexposing it. Oh, stupid thing, but I'll tell you what. In real life, that looks pretty smart. So that's one down. Seven more to go. Right, so I've drilled all my holes now from the fiber optics. All underneath, all in the sides. You probably won't be able to see that too well, but it's in the hole in the side there, and in that side, you might be able to see them, but they're all drilled out. And so now I think it's time to start spraying. So I'm going to get my spray booth set up and we'll have a look at that. Right, so this is my spray booth. It's supposed to be a portable one, but I just have it set up permanently here. Bit of lighting, it's not very well lit, but you know. The primer I'm using is the Tamiya surface primer, and yeah, so let's just turn this on. A little bit noisy, but close to what it's supposed to be. And we'll give this a go. So I don't think that's too bad. I'm going to carry on with the rest of them and that's it. Right, so that's everything sprayed for now. I'm going to let that dry for a little while, quite a while actually, and then we'll start assembling and putting in the fiber optics and the lighting and start gluing it together and then putting all the other bits and pieces on. And then hopefully after that, I think that's going to take me some time because obviously it's the first time I've ever done a lighting kit. I know where the fibres go now, but it's still going to be difficult. It's not going to be easy. I'm going to have to take some bits apart again just to try and feed them in, especially the ones on the bits at the top. So I'm going to leave it for now and then we'll go from there after that. It might be a little while before I do the next update. I don't know, see how it goes. I've got quite a few other things to do today. Thanks for watching and feel free to comment, pass it on, get other people to subscribe, that'd be great. Thank you, bye bye.